Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam, dokter.
Salam warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Okay, so we have
Waalaikumsalam, dokter.
a new topic today. Bahuli, you are in the best of health, yeah? From yesterday, we have a lockdown in the country, so please stay at home. So we can follow the class here from home. Okay, today we have a new topic regarding with the reliability and maintenance. So this the maintenance very important in a organization, yeah, in company. So in order to maintaining the operation or the of the equipment, yeah, machine. Now I will share. Maintenance and reliability. So there are two words that we should understand regarding with this topic: maintenance and reliability. This outline, the main objective. So the objective of maintenance and reliability is to maintain the capability of the system. The system here is the organization. The organization is like a system. If we talk about system, so we have input and output and the process itself and feedback. So this organization is a system. So maintenance and reliability, yeah, in order to maintain the capability, the running smoothly of the system, of the organization. So if we have the organization that failure, yeah, in maintenance, there will be affected the such kind of the list, yeah? Operation of the organization will be affected, will be not smooth. So if a failure of the system or subsystem or machine or tools or equipment, so they will be producing, for example, yeah, producing the scrap, producing the rework. And then, of course, they will affect the profitability. Yeah, if that happen and many times, so when the product of the organization, yeah, having the no good quality, so the reputation of the organization will be affected, as well as the customer satisfaction also. So this is the failure that can happen, yeah, in the system, yeah, organization of the maintenance, yeah, failure, yeah, happen, so then will affect it to many aspects, yeah, the organization. So the it's not good for the organization. So the organization is facing the bankrupt. So this is the how important the maintenance. Yeah, I have informed or discussed with you last time when I was in the oil and gas company. So there are two choices, yeah, regarding to buy the heavy equipment, yeah, whether the new one or the second one. Yeah. So this the difference of the price is 100 million rupiah. So son of the company's owner and the owner itself different perspective. So then they asked me how to decide this situation, whether decision to buy the new one or buy the second one. So in that case, yeah, I choose the old one, because from this I can we can save 100 million rupiah about the 100 million about 30,000 ringgit. Yeah. So this is the case. Why I choose this one? Because in our background, in our data, that we good, yeah, in the maintenance. Yeah, our team in the maintenance team is very good. Yeah, in the maintenance. Yeah, so then they can the maintaining, yeah, the operation of the system, yeah, the organization. So,
excuse me, doctor.
Yeah.
There's someone waiting at me to enter.
Okay.
Thank you, doctor.
So, what is different maintenance and reliability? Okay. So, maintenance is all activities involving in the maintaining the capability of the system. The system can running without any failure, without any trip, without any breakdown. On the other hand, reliability is the probability that the machine, part, or product will function properly for a specified time under stated condition. So the reliability. Yeah. So the two words is very important. So there are two topics in this topic. Yeah. So today maybe we will discuss about the reliability, and then next week we have for maintenance. So reliability related to the individual component. You know, this the reliability is the capability of a machine to run at a certain time. It's very important. Yeah. So how many percent? And yeah, this is the reliability and the percentage, because this is a probability. Yeah. So if we want to calculate the system reliability, then we should see about the individual component. The individual components determine the important role, yeah, in the system or system reliability. Yeah, I have been the working. I have worked in the Mitsubishi in Japan last time. Mitsubishi heavy industry. So we can see the reliability of the component. Yeah. In a system, yeah. At that time, I worked for fabricating or development of a nuclear power plant, so the power plant. So in the power plant, there are thousands of the component there. So then the component, individual component reliability is very important in order to measure or to calculate or determine the whole system reliability of the power plant. Yeah, from the individual, so then we can know. Yeah. So this and then the second one for the reliability is providing redundancy. Yeah. Redundancy when we have a backup, yeah, of a main component, yeah, in order to support, yeah, or to improve or to increase the reliability. Yeah, the reliability is very important if the component fail, yeah, to run or to operate, then the backup will be yeah, take to change, yeah, the main component, yeah, or the main machine. So this is the important. Then the how many backup of the component. This is depends on the value of the reliability itself. For example, the product of Japan and product of America at that time will be different in the reliability. So the backup, the number of the backup component is different from Japanese system and the American system. Since the Japanese reliability component is higher, when I work in the Mitsubishi, so we adapt the American the system at the time, American power plant, and that collaborate with the Mitsubishi to build the power plant in Japan, the nuclear power plant in Japan. So initially, Japan adapt American technology, especially the in my case is a PWR, pressurized water reactor power plant. So at that time, Mitsubishi adapt or collaborate with the Westinghouse to apply the PWR nuclear power plant in Japan. So so we get from the system of the Westinghouse product, so we can have the value of the reliability of component is about 75%. Then within the 10 years, since the some problem could happen in the time, so then the Japanese improve the reliability of component into the 90% or 90 more than 90%. So then this will affect the how many backup component that we will install instead of the main component. So this is the reliability. Maintenance. So the maintenance is very important. Some maintenance method that we adapt in order to maintaining the operation of the system by implementing or improving preventive maintenance. It's very important. So then the maintenance important is increasing repair capability or the speed to repair. And it's very important. Since the trip or the breakdown or the idle time in the system operation is very costly. So then the repair capability and the speed of the repair, this is also important. And this in the maintenance management, so when there are two components that are very important in order to make the result of the system operation. The first is employee involvement. Employee involvement is very important. Employee involvement in terms of what? For example, autonomous, autonomous maintenance. And then the skill training. And then the by applying the reward system, and then the employee empowerment, and then the continuous improvement. So this is regarding with the involvement of the employees. So we should give the self of belonging into their job, their work, or their organization to the all employees. They're very important in order to make the working is best follow the SOP, for example, or follow the company regulation or company instruction, like work instruction, for example, for the SOP, so we can break down into the work instruction. So this is very important. And then the second one, regarding the procedure of the maintenance and the reliability. So for example, the cleaning and lubricating of the machine, monitoring, adjusting, regularly, for example, of the machine, and make a minor report, without waiting for the major repair. So the minor repair is very important. If you can see any small part that should be repaired, do it repairment without any disturbing the operation, the organization or machine. And keep accurate report. Yeah, accurate report is very important. Yeah? And we do not keep the good report or accurate report. So the some maintenance like predictive maintenance or maintenance we plan. Yeah. So then there will be not accurate. So they, if not accurate, then will be costly. Yeah? This is the important. So all of these two components they will result into the reduction of the variability. Yeah, variability will be costly, yeah? And will be reducing the quality. And then reduction of the inventory. If we do the properly, yeah, we can maintain the operation of the machine, operation of the subsystem, operation of the system. Then we can reduce the inventory. Yeah? We should not provide. Yeah, inventory or the spare part. Yeah, that over too many, for example. Yeah, so this will be costly. Or even we should not have inventory. Yeah, we use a method of JIT, just in time. We use our suppliers. Yeah, as our inventory. And then as from this we can improve the quality. Yeah, so in this case, we can improve the performance of the products. Then improve the capacity. Yeah, so the productivity will be increased. The protecting investment in plant and equipment. So if not necessary, so then we should not have additional investment in the plant or equipment. So then the all of this, then the yield, we can gain, yeah, the productivity. And during the globally or regionally, so we can win, yeah, the product. We can win the market of the product. Now, of course, then improve the profitability. Yeah? If we get the improve the profit, and we can also will affect the employee, yeah, satisfaction. For example, we give the bonus, we can give the 13th of the salary in a year. So this is because of the profitability. Now, see about the reliability. Yeah, the reliability of the system, yeah, symbolized by R, yeah, RS, system reliability. And then important, yeah, in the reliability is the improving the individual components. If we improve the individual components, then we improve the whole system. Yeah? We affect the whole system. Yeah, of course, the reliability of a component if increase, then will be more expensive. But by calculation, so we can calculate. Yeah, we can understand whether this is how to improve, yeah, and what is the effect to the performance of the system. So if performance is good, yeah, just now any productivity, profitability, and other factor that will be improved, yeah, will be increased, for example, in the productivity. So assuming the independent component system reliability equal to this, yeah. The system reliability is a dependence of the individual component reliability, yeah, multiplying by the other individual component reliability, yeah, R1, R2, R3, etc. So it's very simple. And then we can see here if we in the system, we have the same component, with the number of component, the different number of components, so the reliability of the system will be different. So, for example, an individual component is a uh, 98%, for example, yeah, 98%. So if the number of the component is one, so this is the average of each component, yeah, 98%. So the reliability of the system, because only one in the system, so this is the reliability depends on the component itself. If in the system we have 10 components with the 98% for individual, so then actually the system reliability is not 98% but 82%. And this is for the number of the component 10. Yeah. So 0.98 multiply 0.98, yeah, until the 10, yeah, 10 components. So we have the result is 80% or 0.8. If the number of the component in the system increase, so this is also will reducing the probability of the system. The system probability will be reduced, yeah, by increasing the number of component in the system. Yeah, so we clear. Then this example, for example, component 1 90%, component 2 80%, and component 3 99%. So what is the system reliability? The system reliability is R1 multiplied by R2 multiplied by R3. So we have 71.3%. So this is the reliability of the system. So the system has three different reliability, different individual reliability. So from this reliability, so we can the basic unit measure for the reliability. The basic unit of the measure of reliability is coming from this. Company, how to calculate or how to measure the reliability of the component? So we can see, from this equation. For example, percentage of reliability and the or the failure rate, the product failure rate, into the product failure rate. So then we can have the reliability. So product failure rate is a basic measure of the reliability. So if we have a number of unit tested, then the number of failure. So then we can have the failure rate of the product is a number of failure over number of unit tested, so multiply 100%. So this is the failure rate of the product. And we can have the another unit, in terms of number of failure. So this is a failure rate of the product into the number of the failure into the unit hours of operating time. So failure rate, product, of the number of failure, defined as number of failures over number of unit hour of operating time. And then other term we can calculate is the mean time between failure, MTBF, 1/FRN. So this is a MTBF. So this term is used when we we will do the maintenance. Yeah. So then the by understanding the mean time between failure, yeah, between the two failure, yeah. So then we can see we can calculate how many percent the reliability, yeah, how many when the, we want to plan to have a maintenance, for example. So this is the FR percentage, yeah, FRN and MTBN. So without we have another term as well, yeah. Beside of the MTBF, yeah, we have the MTTF, yeah, mean time to failure. Mean time to failure and mean time to mean failure. This is an example, yeah, of the failure rate. The example of failure rate, for example, 20 air conditioning units for use in the Soyuz. This is the Apollo, yeah, spacecraft. Belong to the Soviet or Russian. Yeah, so your spacecraft operated for 1,000 hours. Yeah, so then they're launching the Soyuz to the space, and then operate in the 1,000 hours. Yeah, during that operation time, the air conditioning, one of them failed after 200 hours, and another one failed after 600 hours. So the two, there are two air conditioner, yeah, fail, yeah, to complete, to operate as long as 1,000 hours. So then we can have the failure rate, yeah, into the percentage. So two air condition fail over the total number of the air conditioner, 20. Yeah, so we have 20, and the two is a fail, one after 200 hours and another one after 600 hours. So then we have the failure rate is a 10%. Yeah, 10%. Yeah, failure rate of the system is a 10%, or the air conditioner. And then in terms of the number of the unit, yeah, failure rate can be calculated from the number of failure of the air condition, yeah, 2 over unit hours operating. Yeah, so of course it's not if there is no fail, so this 2 over 20 times 1,000, so 20,000. But since the two air conditioner failed after 200 hours, so meaning that the there are 800 hours, yeah, failed to operate. Yeah, yeah, only 200 hours operation. So this another one is after the operation for 600 hours, 400 hours fail, yeah, to operate. So then the unit hours operation, yeah, should be minus, yeah, yeah, the two this, yeah, 20,000 minus 800, yeah, plus 400, so 1200. So then we have this equation, yeah, this calculation. So we can have this the failure rate is 0.000106 failure per unit hour. Yeah. So every 1 unit hour, yeah. So this the probability to failure or to happen is a 0.00106. Yeah. And MTBF 1 over FRN, 9,434 hours. Yeah. This is the mean time between failure. Yeah. So this failure rate example. And also we can calculate the failure rate per trip, yeah. And during per trip is 6 days, yeah. So this failure rate FRN multiplied by 24 hours, 6 days per trip. So we can calculate the failure rate per trip is 0.0153 failure per trip. Now, how to improve the reliability? Yeah. How to improve the reliability? So, as we have discussed just now, that by providing the backup of the component, yeah, as a redundancy, providing backup component to increase the reliability. So, the reliability is a if we have the backup, so the total system reliability is the probability of the first component, yeah, working, plus plus probability of the second component working, yeah, multiplied by probability of needing second component, yeah, yeah, needing of the second component. So needing of the second component means of course, this is the failure, yeah, from this, the probability of the first component is 0.8, for example. So meaning this probability needing second component is the failure, yeah, of the first component, yeah. So needed by, needed for the second component. So this is 1 minus 0.8. Yeah, this is the this probability needing by the second component. Yeah, we calculate from the failure rate. Yeah, the failure rate of the first component, yeah. 1 minus 0.8, and then this is the probability of the second component. If we have the second component is 0.75. Then we can improve, yeah, from 0.8 if in individual component working only without backup. So we have a 0.8. If we backup with the reliability of component is 75%, and then we can have a improvement of the reliability of the system 0.95. Okay. So, example, if we want to improve the reliability of the system by redundancy, by backup component, yeah, this is the example. Yeah, for example, we have the R1, R2, R3. So R1 and R2, there are backup. Yeah, for R1 is 0.09, and for R2 is 0.8. For R1 0.9 and then R2 0.8. So this is same, yeah, same per component. So the reliability same, yeah. But the R3, there is no backup system or backup component. So then we can calculate, yeah, for the R1, yeah, 0.90, yeah, for the first reliability, yeah, working component, and then plus, yeah, plus 0.9, yeah, of the second component, yeah, multiplied by 1 minus 0.0 or probability of the first component. So we have 1 minus 0.9. So we have, and this is for the first, yeah, reliability of a component R1, yeah, so this is there is the improvement here, and multiply for with to the reliability, total reliability of the R2. Yeah, so we have this, and then multiply by the 0.99. Then we can have 0.94. So this is improved, yeah, from the without any redundancy of the component. Okay. From 71.3% into the 94%. So this significant increase by additional of redundancy component. Parallel redundancy, yeah, is another possibility. So for example, we have this parallel, yeah, R1 parallel to R2 and R3 and parallel to R4. So we have a calculation here, yeah, R1 is 0.95, R2 0.975, R3 0.975, R4 0.95. So we calculate the first, yeah, the reliability of the middle path. Yeah, this is the middle path is R2 and R3. So we have we can calculate this one. Yeah. R2 multiplied by R3. So we have 0.9506. Yeah, the multiplication between reliability of component R2 and reliability of the component R3. And then the probability of failure. In order to calculate the reliability of total reliability of the system, so we can calculate, yeah, the failure, the probability of failure of the three component, yeah, R1 and then combination between R2, R3, and R4. So the probability of failure of R1 is a 1 minus 0.95. For the middle path, the probability of failure is 1 minus 0.9506. And then for the probability of failure of R4, yeah, we have 1 minus 0.95. So then we can get this is the probability of failure of the three paths, yeah, first path, second path, and third path. Okay. So then we can have the reliability of a new design, yeah, one minus the probability of failure of the three paths. So 0.00012. So we have 0.99988. So this is almost one. So this is very important. So using the parallel redundancy, so we can see here using the parallel redundancy, so we can reducing the probability of failure. So 9.99, yeah, or 99.988% the reliability of a new system, and then the probability of failure 0.00012. So this is a or 10 power minus 12 times 10 power minus 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, yeah, minus 5. Yeah, this the value seems not important. Yeah. Seem not important. Yeah. 0.00012. Yeah. This is a very small sir. But this is very important, see? So, without any parallel redundancy, so we have among the three components, just now, we calculate about the 71%, right? All right? 71%. But when we improve using the parallel redundancy, then we can have a reliability of the system, yeah, improved 99.988%. Yeah, in the nuclear system, in the nuclear power system. So the decimal number is very important. Yeah, even this very small, yeah, in the nuclear power plant system or individual component or the system. Yeah. So the probability of failure is a for example, yeah, 12 × 10⁻⁷. So how small this one? How small this one? But this maybe in the real operation, the operation of the system, it seems no meaning because it's very small. Yeah. For example, if in this case, 0.00012 means that 12 component failure, yeah, out of 100,000, 12 component fail, yeah, out of 100,000 component. It's very small. Yeah, maybe the probability to occur this failure may be very small, but this very important. Yeah, especially it's not only for the maintenance or predictive maintenance, but this also for the design. In the design of such a system, like very important, yeah, because people may be scary about the nuclear, yeah. So then nuclear power plant, yeah, because they can explode, yeah. So the imagination, the image of the people, nuclear is like atomic bomb, yeah, but actually it's not that one. Yeah, nuclear power plant is very safe. Even the maybe last time there was an accident, a nuclear. This because of the it's not the system itself to work, but because the tsunami, yeah, from external. Yeah, like in the Fukushima. Yeah, last time, yeah, there was the tsunami. So then the seawater come to the emergency generator. So the generator, emergency generator, could not operate and then could not active the safety system of the nuclear power plant. So this is the then the reactor was heated up and then there was a melt, yeah, of the fuel assembly, and then they contaminate to the seawater. Yeah, but this actually this very seldom, yeah, ever the operation of the nuclear power plant. Why? Yeah, because the reliability of the system very very high. Yeah, 99.9999. Yeah, so this is until 7-digit. Yeah, percent. So this is very small. In terms of the safety, yeah, and the reliability is very close to one, or the probability to failure is close to zero, yeah. So this is no meaning actually in the operation, yeah. But for the design, very important. If we can improve the reliability of a new system, yeah, for example, zero point nine 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 eight eight. So you can improve a new design 0.99998. You can improve in this case. So the improvement is to make yeah, of course they make feel safety, feel secure, yeah, when you produce the high reliability of the system or the high reliability of the component, yeah. So this is the parallel redundancy. Okay, on the second topic, yeah, maintenance will be in the next week. Any question about this redundancy or the reliability. Maybe next weeks we have a quiz for the this probability. Yeah. Okay. Any question?
No, no.
Okay, I understand. Yeah. So if we have a quiz about this, you can answer correctly. Okay. If you have no any question, so I will end this class. Some I will tell you. Yeah, some days ago or last 2 weeks. Yeah, there was an accident. Yeah, there was accident of the submarine of Indonesia, and then kill about 53 person. Yeah, Navy. Yeah, and under the sea. So this the submarine of the vessel sink. Deeply and to the 800 meter below the sea level. Yeah, so this is the how important the reliability of the system, reliability of the combination of the all components. Yeah, in that time that the submarine could not submit the or cannot communicate it to the center. Yeah. To the center of the Navy, yeah. So it considered that there was the blackout of the system. So this very very important that the maintenance and then the reliability of the system. Yeah, when we understand about the reliability of the system, then we can feel secure. Yeah, when we operate, like in a submarine. So this is how important the maintenance and the reliability of the system. Okay, if you have no any questions, so let's end this class and kita jaga kita and selamat hari raya. So because hari raya is coming, so we celebrate hari raya without any celebrating with the jiran, tetangga, kawan-kawan. Tidak balik kampung, sudah balik kampung semua nih ya. Oke, okay. So saya mengucapkan selamat hari raya bagi yang merayakan dan terima kasih atas partisipasi dalam kelas ini. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.
Waalaikumsalam.
Selamat raya, Doktor.
Okey, terima kasih.
Thank you, Doktor. Selamat raya.